Yeah, okay, so welcome. This is a new YouTube video starting now, so sorry about this, guys on YouTube and everybody else watching on Twitch right now. Yeah, sorry about the text quality. So we're having super duper crazy internet issues here in my at the Wizard Foos pad today. And also you're not gonna be able to hear my sound great on OBS because OBS is horrible for its recording. But anyways, I'm gonna try and stream today anyways with lower quality settings. So I don't know, this is gonna be a okay, so you like the frame rate, cool. Well, let's see how it looks with the game playing. It's probably gonna be horrible audio quality because you're hearing it through my laptop speakers. But how's the frame rate looking? If you guys can see clearly, I started progress on the game being totally resolution independent. So it's filling up the whole screen instead of letterboxing now. Game looks good, cool. So you can see right now it's using my whole screen instead of how it used to. Oh, nice. It's even more pixely. Well, maybe that's good then. Oh, I gotta turn down my frame rate on the game. Sweet, sweet. Ferk, what's up? And welcome everybody else too. Pizza, Salad Dongs, Jonah, Boogie, Hyrule Spy, Rocket Bunny, everybody else on the stream. Sorry for the poor quality today. My internet's crap. But I'm trying to stream at a lower quality anyways. So it doesn't affect the game's text at all. Yeah, it shouldn't. Yeah, because it's pixel art, right? Ferk, by the way, thanks for playing the game, Ferk. So many great things I noted when I watched Ferk play a few days ago. Evening, Stig. Stig. So yeah, I'm gonna be coding today, kind of at a lower resolution, so but I'm working on the ending of the game right now. So I'm gonna warp the player to level 9 and start working there, working on the credits sequence and all that. Yeah, it does get really dark. You like that? Oh, pizza, is your Steam working finally? Did you finally able to update? Yeah, so Ferk, I'm making the ending of the game right now. It's not gonna be the whole story sequence for the ending. But at least you'll be able to complete the game now. Yes, definitely, Rocket Bunny. Yeah, Ferk. So, also, I've updated today as well. So, there's been another update, and tonight I'm gonna update to the Steam again with more of these fixes and stuff. Yeah, totally, Salad Dongs. Yep, just that. No bass because it's coming through my laptop. Awesome. Yeah, all right. So yeah, welcome to the stream, you guys. Sorry for all the crazy internet problems. But you can see, oh, Ferk, another big thing is I'm filling up the whole screen now, so there's gonna be no more letterboxing. And that's gonna be something I work on later, but you can tell when I walk from this area to that area, there's a little black bit of area that I haven't filled in yet, but it is using the whole screen. So you can see that on the main menu pretty clearly. It's using my entire laptop screen instead of just letterboxing on the edges. Nice, Ferk. You think Jib should produce a little source of light? Yes, yeah, Jib. That's one of the things on the Trello. So yeah, I want to mention that too on the stream here. And that's the Trello. So if anybody, yeah. Nice, yeah, Rocket Bunny, I saw that. So yeah, if anybody hasn't seen this is the Trello. If you've been playing the update, it does have the link to this. But let me post a link in the chat as well because this is great. This is a great way to post like thoughts and things I'm working on and bugs, stuff like that. Thanks, Salad Dongs. Yeah, I worked on that a lot the past few days. I worked on making the shadows more dramatic and darker and like and dialing in the levels and stuff like that. So here's one of my top things is filling up the entire screen even on squarier ratios. But yeah, let me post a link so you guys have this if you're curious about what's being worked on, what the top issues are. That's gonna be Twitch chat. So here's that link to the Trello. And yeah, if anybody wants to post in here, you know, onto the Trello, like if you want to post some bugs you found or whatever, feel free to email me or whatever. You can email me at nat@wizardfoo.com and I'll add you to the Trello. And then if you are going to add bugs, I'd ask if you put it just here in this unofficial findings. Boogie started doing that. And then later I'll go in and check out the new things you guys have mentioned for unofficial findings or whatever. And I'll move them over to things I'm working on or where they should go and add priority with the color system and all that. All right. Okay, so let's do this. All right, so level 9, when you beat it, I'm going to make basically I've got an item already where you pick up this mystery item or whatever and it ends the game. So I'm going to put the area into that or the player into that area now. Yeah, pizza, what's your how do I add you to the Trello? What are you? Scottish pizza? I know, you're Scottish pizza at Gmail. Are you on here already, Scottish Pizza? Yeah, thanks, Boogie. Yeah, thanks for coming up with that. That's a great system, by the way. Adding this unofficial findings was a great way for that Boogie came up with for adding stuff, you know, for people, you know, for you guys. This is a great place for you guys to put stuff. So then later I can go and kind of like, because I already know where everything is and I know which, because there's a lot of bugs already. You know, so sometimes there's duplicates and sometimes you just need a little bit of attention, you know? Okay, so this room I tested earlier today. It's really fun to play. There's some improvements I will definitely be making later, but I just want to focus on the ending of the game right now. So this is like the boss room, and here we go. Here we're in this ending room or whatever. Yeah, so what are you on Trello? Okay, so if I pick up this item, it'll start the credit sequence. I already started this last night. Oh, Scottish Pete, that's what I just typed in. Oh, I found you that time. There you go. You're on there now. So yeah, once again, just please post into the unofficial findings thing. And if you do, okay, and also Scottish Pizza, if you notice something on here, you know, do try and look through and see if something is already listed. You know, maybe you might find that this bug has already been mentioned. And if you do, then you can comment on it too. So you can go and like, you can add a comment to something else or add a screenshot or whatever. So that would help me out a lot if you could find, you know, try and find and see if the bug is already mentioned. Level generation algorithm, cool. Oh, it's an EXE? Ah, dang. Oh, I'd love to check that out. I might have to check that out later, though, on Windows. Okay, so, yeah, I've got this item all set up. So if I pick up this item, it's going to end the game. Of course, this is not going to, there's going to be a lot more story that's going to happen here when you end the game, but really all I want to do today is just get it so, it's the basic process, right? It's just the mechanics. Like, you pick up this item, the game's done, and you won. You completed it. You know, there's not going to be, basically it's not complete, it's not the story, but it's at least something, right? So now he just puts down the sword, and then it's going to fade in, show the credits. And inside these credits, I want to start doing some, like, it's going to show all the areas of the game. Just like how, like, Zelda did when after you beat the game and it was rolling the credits, it would show lots of different areas. What if you don't pick up the item? Jonah, yeah, I'm going to make it so you can't even leave this room without picking up the item. So it's like, you know, there's not going to be that. Let's do that right now. I'll take away this teleport thing here in this room. So really your only choice is either to pick up the item or leave the, you could actually leave the room, but then it's just the same thing. Because really all that happens here is that it doesn't even save the game. All it does is you pick up the item and then bam. Yeah, you saw your name? A lot of these are, you guys have probably seen your names in here. Okay, so yeah, let's take away that portal. Where does it put the portal again? Is that an exit desk? I forget where that's all triggered from. Portal. No. It's an exit desk, I'm pretty sure. Oh, it's in the it's gonna be in area patterns. One of these, yeah, pattern goal teleport field. Let's see if I take that out, if it's gone. You didn't see your name, Jonah, your name's in there. Right? I'm pretty sure you're in there. Let me see. Yeah, you're there. Jonah19. There's a lot of backers, though. A lot of supporters. And once again, thank you, everybody. Freaking so awesome. This game would not be possible without all of your support. Scottish Pizza's in there, too. You're there. Right? Or did you put some other kind of name in here? Did you reply to my email about that? Maybe you haven't replied yet. Oh no, that's right, you're Ewan. Right? Yeah, there you are. Okay. So I think that'll work if I just comment out the goal teleport field. Let's see if that works, and then I'll do it proper where it checks if this is the last goal room. Yeah, you're there. Oh, great. Cool. So it's gone. Good. So this needs to be if. I'm trying to think of the most proper way to do this. I think the best way to do this is to search for the item that's called the ending item. It's just as easy to go. Area to pause.z. is less than k world num levels. So the very last level is going to have so all the other levels should have teleport fields, and then this last one won't have a teleport field. Are you a full Apple or half and half with Windows? Oh, yeah, half and half. Yep, I got the boot camp, so I rebooted into Windows to build the game there and all that. Okay, cool. So now we just have this item. Let's make sure that the other worlds or the other levels, like level 8, for example, also still has a teleport field. don't know where this level is going to be, but let's start exploring. I guess I should have looked at the map. Whoops. Oh, damn it. So I'm looking for the boss room. Oh, here it is. Great. Still has it. Ferk, no, cheats are not in the release. But I've got some ideas on how they can be in the release. In fact, this is such a fun thing, God mode, right? It's like so cool to be able to run this fast. I think I'm gonna make it some the boots item make you run faster. So as soon as you find the boots, you're gonna be able to run a lot faster. It'll never be God mode, right? Where you'll be able to like walk on sky and walk through walls and stuff. But at least you'll be able to go faster. Yeah, there's a lake that blocks a path. Pizza, I just fixed that. Yeah, I fixed that this morning. Let me show you that that issue. I totally fixed that already, and yeah, that's been reported a couple times, so I'm really glad to have that fixed already. So like level one, I think right above, yeah. So this room right here is a good example. So right now this is all fixed. That means the red areas are collision boxes. But let me show you what it was like this morning. It's in wall. Where's wall? Yeah, you can walk on water if you have God mode, but that's only in debug mode. So this morning the game was like this. I accidentally had 2B for the walls. It was a single character fix. It's very, very easy. So now you can see the walls are like really tight. And if I walk even like up here, I can't walk by through there. So that was a super big bug. I'm glad to have that fixed. So once again, putting that back to 1B. Oh no, you walked on water? How did you do that? So now it's fixed again. Okay, so turn off God mode, turn off invincible, go back to level 9. Let's get ready to do this ending credits. You did too? How did you guys do that? Did you get knocked onto the water somehow? Oh, you thought it was just shallow? It was. It totally was. It was just shallow. It was a feature. Totally intentional. Oh right, while moving scenes. Okay, yeah, that's a bug already. I've already listed that. But I would love to see a screenshot of that. So Pizza, if you happen to take a screenshot of that, I would love to see what area you got that happening for you. Okay. Yeah, sorry Andrew. Yeah, internet problems, super bad all week. I don't know why, but my upload speed's been just complete shit. So I've had to lower the quality. You didn't take a screenshot? Great. Please comment. Okay, let me show you where to comment for that. It's on here. Here it is. It's called Can Walk South Onto Bombable Pillars. It's the same thing for water. If you walk across an area, you know, if you switch areas, you can accidentally walk on top of stuff. So if you post a screenshot in here, that would be awesome. Yeah, I'll edit this so it says bombable pillars, water, etc. Okay, so yeah, for people just joining the stream today, I'm working on the credits. Oh, cool, man. First, I'm going to make it so the credits, when it's rolling these credits, it's going to show different areas of the game. So that's my first little task, is to start, while it's rolling these credits in the background, it's going to show different areas and do some slight scrolling across the areas and stuff. So let's do this. This is going to be in flux. Flux phase credits. So this is going to be really, really sweet, because now the game will finally be completable. You know, as you, if you do actually happen to play all the way through and you get to level 9, you beat it, you've technically can actually finish the game now. Oh, you're on top of a lily pad? Those are technically supposed to be water anyways. It's stupid question time. What? There's no such thing as a stupid question. Why is it all white and black for me? Let's try this again. Oh, you don't have any stupid questions? Because they don't exist. Oh, so did you walk? How did you walk onto that Scottish pizza? Did you walk from the left, from the right, from below? How did you get there? Maybe you're Jesus. Maybe you're just, you've seen like the Da Vinci Code? Maybe you're the bloodline of Jesus Christ himself. You are the Holy Grail. From the left. Okay, cool. Please note that. Please note that when you're putting it on there. Yeah. Yeah, you should definitely still be able to. Yeah, the game hasn't been fixed there, so that's why. It's a consistent thing, because it's just, you know, luckily it's a consistent thing. Not all bugs are that way. Consistent bugs are the best kind. They're the easiest to find. Right? Okay, so while it's rolling these credits, I want it to be like showing different areas. Okay, so we need a function that when it's called, or the lake's frozen. Dang, you got over 1,000 points. It's about sticker time for you. You got a Steam key? All right. You got to email me, Rocket Bunny. Yeah, like seriously, I would love to give away Steam keys and stickers. So maybe we should decide this right now, actually. How many points should be a Steam key and how many points should be a sticker? Because, I'd love to start giving these out. Like maybe 1,000 points gets you a Steam key, and maybe like 500 points gets you a sticker. Right? But you can still get a sticker. Yeah, you totally, you can still give it to a friend. Yeah. I guess 1,000 points is good. 1,000 points for, right? It's a point per minute. Oh yeah, so Ferk, you get the points for just watching. If you watch the stream, you get some points. It's all thanks to BotFu. Is this bot that Boogie wrote? So BotFu like tracks everybody's how long they've watched, and that gives you get points for every minute you've watched. You got to check the null video. It's so funny. So What do you guys think about that? 1,000 points, you get a Steam key. 500 points, you get a sticker. Yes, Boogie is a legend. Oh, and you have to be following. That's right. Yeah. Right, the null video? Yes, right. Yes, you can. Yes, Rocket Bunny. Wait, how about this? Let's set it. I'll do a straw poll for this. See how many points should you have? How many points required to get a Steam key for Songbringer? 500, 1,000, 1,500, 2,000. Well, okay, so here's that, the straw poll. What's up, Gutting? Yeah, this is the most important question here. How many points for this for the Steam key? Yeah, how much is a, I think Boogie has the answer here on that. I think it's 1 point per minute or 1 point every 5 minutes or 5 points per minute. Shit, I don't know. It's already split even. What's up, Panaliti? No, I've not finished the game. No, this is the late alpha stage. It's almost ready for beta. And in fact, you know what? Oh yeah, let's totally decide this right now too. So let me do another straw poll. I want to know when I should be beta. In fact, I'm thinking about making the beta version like right now, like even like next Wednesday, it would be the beta version. So really, all that would change is that there would be more backers that could get access to play the game right now, and also from now on, just $32 would get you access to the game. So right now, Songbringer pre-order. You can pre-order the game for any of your pre-orders will get you your name in the credits, but the $32 one will get you access to the beta, and the $64 one gets you the access right now. So basically, I'm considering making next Wednesday's release the very first beta release, and then on you'd be able to get the game for $32. And this is all to honor the Kickstarter. You know, the Kickstarter, this is how it was for the Kickstarter. $64 got you the game. At a certain point, $32 got you the game at another point. So, yeah. So for making the Twitch bot, he just used C Sharp and an IRC library. Beta should be day 300. Okay, all right. So, well, yeah, let's see what you guys all think here. When should Songbringer's beta phase start? Next Wednesday. Okay, I'm thinking February 21st might be a rad day to start it. Because February 21st, if you guys didn't know, is the release date of Zelda 1, 1986. Songbringer is 30 years, ex almost exactly 30 years from then, Songbringer is released. Here. That's good enough. Or at least a rounded number. Once you get the points, you have like a 1 in 4 chance to actually win the key. Is that good? Sure, I guess. Yeah, I mean, I guess you win something else, right? You don't just lose your points, right? I don't know. Forget the poll. Just do the February 21st. Just FYI, there was a straw poll exploit the other day that added a ton of phony votes. Oh. Okay. All right. Yeah. Well, I hope that won't happen, Saw Dongs, because it's just meant for the next like 5 minutes. That's really all I'm gonna check is just from you guys watching the stream. But yeah, I'll definitely keep that in mind if there does tend to be too many results. But yeah, if you guys didn't see this, look at this. The Legend of Zelda. Original release date, February 21st, 1986. Bam! February 21st. So I just think that would be a great day to make special somehow. So even if the beta isn't released on February 21st, I'll make this somehow a special day for Songbringer and just honor like Zelda because it's such a rad game. So how are we doing on this results, eh? Oh, we got February 21st with 6 votes. Well, yeah, who chose next Wednesday? I kind of like this next Wednesday myself. But yeah. Wow, dude, look at this. We're totally even on this one. 3 votes for 2,000, 2 votes for 500, 2 votes for 1,000. Huh. Yeah, thanks, Aldonks. Oh my god, Scottish pizza. Dude, nice guitars. You got bass guitars, beautiful Gibsons, nice acoustics, dude. I'm starting to drool here. Yeah, we all voted to delay the release date. Thousand, please, please. Okay, I'll keep this open for a little bit and keep on doing some development. So we're trying to debate here. If you just joined the stream, we got two little straw polls going on. One is how many points you should have on the stream to get your Songbringer key, and you get those just from watching if you're subscribed. And the next question is, when should Songbringer's beta phase start? All right, cool. Okay, so I'm gonna make a function which loads a different area. They are kind of hard. I mean, well, it's not really that difficult. You just watch, but yeah. I think beta should be when everything is finished, like art, story, mechanics, and you're just fixing bugs. Yeah, I hear you there, but I kind of want to make it more accessible to people. So I think I'd rather have a longer beta phase and just like let people start playing the beta, you know. And then keep fixing more and more and more and release lots of updates. I mean, I've released like 3 updates to Steam this week or whatever. So it's not that hard as long as I keep the game kind of, tip top. Yeah, true, pizza. True. Yeah, I don't want to make the points too low because it has, you know, technically it's a pretty expensive thing to pay for, and that's one thing that's definitely why I'm asking you guys, because oh shit, we got 300 votes already. Damn, ruined. Well, I mean, I guess I can tell that only one person voted for next Wednesday, so beta is when you add the word beta to the title screen. Like it. It's one point per minute. Yeah, true. Space my name. I agree with you there on the technically what beta should be. And I think it Songbringer pretty much is pretty close to that right now, where the core game is pretty complete. I mean, there are some things to be added, but really the core game is playable all the way through. So, and I'm making sure of that right now. So, yeah. I know, I should have put a captcha on there. Yeah, I got exploited that fast. Yep. Oh well. Pema, thanks for that vote, Pema. Yeah, but wait, I'm pretty sure, you know, I got the gist, right? February 21st is what you guys prefer for beta, so that's cool to know. And this straw poll is kind of up in the air. Huh. All right. All your points are gone? That's all. That's the that should be debated too. Like when you try to see your points, you just do you do exclamation point points. And you have to be following. Yeah, Jonah 1-9 did it for you there. So this is going to be a function to load display a new area. So I want to do a random function that gives me a function that gives me a random position in the world. Yes. Rocket Bunny definitely. Oh, his points aren't gone. They're in a form of a Steam key. All right, cool. Book. All right. Great. So, Rocket Bunny. Oh, I got your Twitter. Yeah, if yeah, Rocket Bunny, if you'd send me a private message on Twitter, just send me your email so I can email you the Steam code. 'Cause yes, you won, man. I'm thinking about 1,000 points and yeah, let's leave it at 1,000 points for now. 1,000 points, you get it. You can earn a Steam key. Right, Pema? I don't know. Right, good job, Twitch. What's up with that? Twitch has pause, set pause here. Static V3I, get random pause. So this function will be used for just looking through every single area in the entire world and returning one randomly. Yeah, what does the Steam key do? It gives you the game. So you can in Steam you enter that code or the key and it unlocks permanent access to the game. So you can play the alpha, you can play the beta coming up, you can play the final version when it comes out and everything. Oh, Pima, what? How do you add something to a Trello board? You have to be a member of it, and then you just go, you just click the add a card. So you would do it here. Unofficial findings, you go add a card. So I'm adding a function which returns a random world position, so I can do a cool like overlay when the when it's rolling the credits. All right, so this is get random pause. Yeah, you have to be a member of the board though, and I added you already, so you should be a member of Songbringer's board. So, given all of the area's sizes, right? So world dot areas dot, right? That's areas is a yeah, it's just V3I hash type area. So areas dot size. Rip Trello board? Oh no. What happened to it? Don't tell me this got destroyed or something. It seems fine. Stay alive, Trello board. I love you. You're awesome. You're the best way to track bugs ever. So we'll get an index. Using DRAND of world areas.size. Yeah, that's the mod. Oh, no, I don't. What's that? What's that mean? LN before? Or is it IN before? In before. Oh, in before rip. Oh, in before rip. Okay. Sorry, I didn't know that one. What's up, Jules? Just double checking the crafting bug that includes crafting the lightning sword. Yes. Yeah, it probably had to do with that crafting bug. So, yeah, I'll get that fixed for tonight's release. I'm gonna release another update tonight to Steam with as many bug fixes as I can. Yeah. Ah, sleep, right? Sleep. Can't underestimate how important that is. World areas. At. No, I want to go world areas dot begin plus index. Oh, it's second. What's up with this? Yeah. Pizza. Yeah, the end, the final boss. I'm just making it's past the final boss. After you beat the final boss, this is just the sequence that runs when the game is done. It's not going to be any of the story just yet. The story is going to be later, like months from now, I'm going to be adding the story and stuff. Right now, I'm just adding the core bits of gameplay. So this is just something where if you do happen to beat the game right now, at least the game will complete. It's a completable game finally. Three stars? What? Will you stream your next game? Probably. What's up, Game Vivo? Let's try this. Oh, fail already. Yeah, Jules, sorry, man. My internet's really crappy today, so I had to lower the quality to even get the stream to work. So, and also the audio quality's bad today. It's not just OBS. It's because I'm. It's not OBS. Is really. I had to lower the settings quality like really ridiculously. So I'm not even sure if you can read what I'm typing here. Oh, this doesn't work. Hash map iterator plus index. Oh no, why is this whole thing red? Is that like broken or something? Or did somebody change the background color? Well, I bet you it's just somebody messing with the background color. Oh yeah, I thought it was somebody. It broke. I'm like, God damn, it can't be broken already. Right, so all I want to do is return a random position from the world. I'm going to just get a random area. This is an unordered map. How do you get a random element from an unordered map? Dude, I don't know. How do you do that? Do I have a pet? No, I don't have a pet right now. I really would love a dog, or even a cat, or both, or two cats and two dogs. But really, we need like a bigger place for that. We have a real tiny apartment. Oh, standard next. Using begin. Select a valid round number. It simply wraps the standard advance function in a way. Okay. So I could have just written my own for loop. It would have been kind of the same thing. So it will go, is that it returns an iterator? Yeah, auto it equals next. World.areas given index. Maybe I have to make that standard. Still doesn't like it. You have a dwarf hamster? Cool. Yeah, 83. It's pixel stream today. Sorry, my internet quality is real bad. Jules, you want to fund your game on Kickstarter? Sweet, dude. Yeah, Jules, I got tons of advice for you, man. Check out this Gamma Sutra article. Damn, it didn't work. Oh, begin edges. Standard begin edges, not edges that begin. What the hell is the difference between standard begin and regular begin? Oh, Boogie got that link for you already. Looks like it's working now. Yeah, what does the red dot on the map mean? It's just where the boss is. Can you take a screenshot of that? Because you might have to go around the lake to get to it. It probably is accessible. I've fixed a lot of those bugs, but there's a chance there could be a bug. So if you can, just send a screenshot of that. Okay, so what's the difference if I do this? Can I do world areas dot begin? Oh yeah, same thing. Oh my God, what's the difference between these? Yeah, no, it could be accessible, man. You just have to go to a different, oh. Have you tried walking around? Have you tried going a different way to get there? Because it very much could be accessible from a different part of the lake. But if you've walked completely around there and you definitely cannot get there. Oh, wait. Oh, I think I see what you're saying though. Maybe since you don't have the bombs yet, you can't get around there. Okay, so you did walk around at all. Okay, no, I trust you. Tell me, okay, so when if you could please post this on there on the Trello, just post this screenshot, and also tell me what world seed you used so I can go check it out myself and figure out I can, test to see if I can if I fixed it, all right? So just let me know your world seed. It happened to you too, Jules? Okay. Oh, so you can use standard to begin on arrays, dude. Okay, great. But I definitely don't need to use standard begin. Okay, so I can just get that iterator, make sure it's not. I'll keep that as standard next. That's such a short word. Hey, what's up, Elite SCV? Yeah, lag script. Sorry, man. My internet's crap today. I had to lower the quality settings. So yeah, the stream is just horrible quality today. But at least it's a stream. The last 3 days I haven't even been able to stream because my upload speed is just crap. I've called support for Comcast and it's just yeah. I'm gonna have to call them again and try and figure out once again. Okay, so this gets a random position from the world. It chooses one. This is just gonna be put in there. There, so we got get random pause. Is Kickstarter money transferred to PayPal? No. No, when you sign up for Kickstarter, you give them your bank details and everything, and they just do a transfer. Map shows connection to the left. Oh, wow. Did you try walking down there in the bottom left? If you did try walking down the bottom left, then there's definitely a bug there. So please, for bugs like that, definitely sh share that screenshot and share the world seed that you're on, and that's all I really need, and I'll figure it out. Good bug catches, you guys. Thanks you. Yeah, Sergeant Sam, right? Comcast. Yeah. So why is it poor stream quality today? Comcast. Sorry about that. Nice, you're working on C book exercises. Good for you, Elite SCV. Yes, all you had to say was Comcast. It's an internet provider, Rocket Bunny. Okay. So I want to make a function. Let's see. Let's get. Let's see what. Hold on. Auto. Show new area equals something. So we're gonna get the new position. World get random pause. If pause is invalid, return. Otherwise, we could do a shift to the new area. Let me just check how it does the slide. The slide gets rid of the old area. World set pause, new area pause. World create area. And then there's one more function which removes the old area. World area, old area pause, delete entities. That should be all. So I can go back to phase credits. This is going to be world area, old area pause dot delete entities. So an old area pause is just world get pause, and then new area pause. Oh, actually, this is simpler than that. But this might actually be necessary. Actually, world get pause. Right, so this is just old area pause, new area pause. So it deletes the old area, sets the position, creates a new area. And then we just call it. Oh, I know, pointers? Yeah, pointers are hard. But once you get used to pointers, they're just really just a memory address. Oh, yeah. Comcast Time Warner, yeah. Okay, so, yeah. This is going to call, I'm just going to call this a bunch of times, like every second or so. So I can go game scene, scene, schedule, this needs to take a float, I'm going to totally ignore, function being called is show new area, interval is every, let's say 1, 2, 3 seconds or so it does this, repeat for, oh, this needs to be, we need to know how long this whole duration of everything is. Thanks for the follow. Okay, so this repeats how many times? It's gonna be flux duration. Actually, let's do a const float. Area duration, 3 seconds per area. Area duration, flux duration over area duration, and then CLF that. Delay, 0 seconds, just run it right away. Key, show random areas. All right, let's see if this works. Yeah, null definitely helps with the pointer issue. Okay, see what happens. Oh, hey, there, it showed an area. It even had enemies. Oh, but it started doing music. So really, it shouldn't be doing music here of all these areas. The music system's going crazy. Okay, so how can I make it so it doesn't do music? I guess I could set a silence timer on the music. So music system set silence timer for flux duration. Oh yeah, definitely a smoother transition. I'm working on that. So we got fade. I've already got an existing fade layer. But I know, I guess the area should have its own separate fade layer. So it fades in, yeah, underneath the fade. So that's oh no, you know what? I've already got the fade layer in place. So it's better to just make the fade layer run its own thing. So we got const float fade time and const float area duration. And the fade layer can just go fade in at first, delay for an area's duration, and then keep doing that for a while. So repeat, create. Yeah, totally. It'll have, yes, Jules, it'll totally have all that kind of stuff. It's gonna have its own special music. It's gonna have a tally, kind of like Metroid. So before it even does any of these credits, it's gonna show your completed percentage of the game, and that's gonna be how many items you complete. So you get an item percentage, you get a map percentage, and you also get a time percentage, which is like how fast you completed it, which is kind of like opposite of like 100. I'm not exactly sure how the time completed will work, but basically it's just how fast you completed the game. That produces your overall score for the leaderboard. All right, so this is going to repeat a sequence of fading in, delaying, and fading out. So sequence create null pointer. Oh, and I should get number of times this runs. Bob Food 2.0. Okay, so this fades in. No, wait, it's gonna fade out, I guess. Yeah, I guess it should just fade out. So fade out, create, or fade to is always better than fade out, fade in. So fade out over a second ish down to zero. Fading into, let's do another const float or const in fade opacity that fades into 64. Oh no, oh no. It's stuck in permanent 2D mode? I'm pretty sure you can fix it, man. There's got to be a way to change that in Unity. And Scottish Pizza, please tell me you've been checking it into GitHub or to Git. You should have a Git repo even for your Unity projects. It's Unity stores its projects in XML form. You can totally check in your project. Yeah, Pedro, it's a working stream, but the quality's horrible. Welcome, man. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay, so this is going to fade to fade opacity. This is going to fade out and then fade back in to fade opacity. This is where it delays some time. Create. What's up, dudes and dudettes? Yeah, it's 8-bit. It's an 8-bit stream. That's what it is, right? Okay, so this is the area duration minus the fades to 2.0f for the two fades. And this might as well call a new area right here within this whole system. Okay, so it starts off really. Oh, this is pretty easy. It creates a new area. Oh, and this when it fades to, it needs to fade to 255. That's right. So call func. Create and oh, it looks like we just pass in a regular. It doesn't need a float anymore. So show new area there. No need to take a float. So it shows the new area. It fades in for the fade duration. And now the fade duration or fade time. So area duration, okay, that needs to be overall area duration is now going to be 2 times the fade time or 10, 13, no, 13 seconds per area. Yeah. Oh, you can stop worrying about someone cloning my game. I guess so, right? You can't even read this, right? The text. Yeah, sorry about that. So, what I'm gonna do is so basically, Pedro, it's been this way for my internet for the last 3 days. Yesterday, I called Comcast, and they're like, "Oh, there is a problem with your modems. Come on in. We'll give you a new modem." I spent the whole afternoon going into freaking Comcast, getting a new modem, taking it back home, installing it. Good news is it downloads hella fast. It's like I get 3 times the download speed I used to, but the upload speed is still horrible. I can only get 5 megs a second up. So there's something wrong with my upload speed, and the firmware on the modem is all the way updated. It's a brand new modem. It's something on Comcast's end, I think. So I'm gonna try calling them again tomorrow, and if not, I don't know what to do. I guess I'll just keep streaming this poor quality for now. I don't know. Yes, the depurposing null pointer. You could watch that video over and over. Oh no, dude. No, it's here. I'm telling you, dude, you didn't waste it, man. I'm telling you, there's got to be a setting or something you could figure it out. Hey, what's up, Arcane? This is the end of the game. I'm working on the credits and basically making it so the game is completable. Stream from Starbucks. Spymore, what's up? Yeah, I mean, at least it's a stream, right? So I'll try and talk more about what I'm doing in coding. So basically, I'm coding something right now that it's a sequence, right? That runs when you're running the credits, and it fades in. It creates a new area, fades in. So behind the as the credits are rolling, behind it, there's a sequence that's running where it creates a new area, fades it in. And then delays for a little while, fades out, and then creates a new area. So it keeps showing you more and more and more of the world. So I got a call function to create the new area. This is the fade to fade opacity. Delay time, area duration minus fade time times 2. And then fade time 255, and then it'll repeat. That's it. After this, we remove self. Let's try that. Right? Some guys, right? McDonald's, some guys. I know, I'm programming pixel art today. All right. Nice. No worries, Pedro. No worries, man. I do want to send you. So, Pedro, I'm going to send you a custom EXE. Because you're playing on Windows, right? I'm going to send you a custom EXE for playing the game on Windows. So you can record some input you're getting from your Steam controller. Nice. It's working. So we got some backgrounds fading in of some random areas. No music, though, but it'll have a special music. Flint's Pixel, why Mac? I find it's just more stable and fast. I'm more comfortable on it. I can develop a lot faster than I can on Windows. I like Windows, too. I'm on Windows. I do the Windows build. I sometimes stream from Windows as well. Okay, so yeah, you're on Windows. So I'll definitely send you a custom EXE. Yeah, the final boss is, I mean, no, I'm not, I'm, the final boss is not done. The story sequence for this ending is not done either. There's a lot of stuff that's left to do. I just want to make it so the game is completable. So you when you get this far, you can say, okay, I beat the game. Can the music have a bass drop? Of course. You saw your name that time? Nice. All right, hey, it worked. I can't believe this all worked on the first try. Is it maybe fading in a little too slow, though? Actually, now that the music's, it's fading slower, maybe I don't even need that silence timer thing. Let's try this again. Yeah, you saw Jonah, nice, you saw your name. Pedro, you're there. I think you were at the beginning, right? Wait, hold on. Let me check if Pedro's in there. What's your name on the credits? PMH? Yeah, you're right there. You're one of the top ones. You'll see yourself right away. And fade a little faster? Okay, let's try a little faster fade. Let's do a fade duration time. Let's do, instead of 5 seconds, we'll do 3333 seconds. Yeah, there's a lot of names to go through here. So many people have supported this project, and I'm so thankful forever. I know, yeah, it's hard to see with the pixels, right? Yeah. But you will be able to play this tonight. If you can complete the game, I'll be uploading this to Steam tonight, so if you can get this far in the game, you will actually see all the credits and all that. Check it out. That's a secret area. Cool. Now it's playing the music from each area. All right, right, good night, Jules. See you, man. You can play, but you can't build? Cool, pizza. Seems like an improvement. Boogie! Creeper! Hey, you know what? Let's make all the gold backers gold on this. That would be pretty cool. You saw it? Yeah, you saw it that time. Sweet. I love seeing, like, enemies just standing there. Oh no, check it out! It gave you the fire? Oh, that's because it showed a, story mode. That's crazy. Okay, let's fix that really quick, too. When it's showing, there's the... What system is that? It's the... Oh, the gear... The item system? No, there's no item system. Gear system. When it's hovering, like in its... I think it's gear system tick, actually. Yeah, NM show item info. Let's make this, and world, no, game scene, hero, 0.render.sprite.isVisible. Okay, so let's make sure that the player can, I can still see, use the items. So I want to get back to 0.89. Let's store that, and let's get to the store, negative 200. Yeah, golden names, definitely. That'll be the next thing. Yeah. Yeah, some have double quotes, some have single. That's because that's how people entered them. You know, that's I guess that's their choice, right? I'm just kind of keeping it that way for now. I mean, I could make it so the quote just replaces all double quotes with single quotes, or the other way around. Okay, good. So that still works. Oh, and by the way, if you purchase a bomb container, you can leave the store and go back in, and you can purchase items or you purchase bombs instead. So if you've purchased that bomb container, you can later go back and get bombs, and you can keep filling up too. Yeah, I guess it doesn't matter. I saw that too. I noticed that. I was like, I kind of like to change this, but I guess I'm kind of honoring whatever people chose to put for their name. So, okay, so let's go back to the end of the game. And this time let's make the gold backers gold. So it's Flux. So it does gold backers. The last... Gold, I need a string for the last gold backer now. Title scene uses it. Here it is, last gold backer. So this needs to become a constant. Extern const string. Okay, last gold backer. Put that into constants. It's working! Yeah! Nice pizza! Just... Yeah, sorry, Wissiso. My internet quality's crap, and so I'm streaming in pixel mode right now because this is the best that my stream can accomplish for today. I've had problems with Comcast all week, and I've been trying to work them out. But for now, this is better than not streaming at all. So hopefully by next week, either they'll have fixed their shit or they'll have fixed the shit that's with my personal internet. I don't know what it is. So, last gold backer. Yeah, pizza. Nice job. Two, I told you you could get it. Yeah, welcome to the stream though, Wish Sub. Okay, so I got this string for last gold backer now. I can use it in the title scene as well as in the credit scene. All right, so back to the credits. Okay, so I'm gonna need two separate arrays here. I need backer lines and lines. The backers. Okay, so I can clean up these strings better anyways. So I'm gonna split the backers. By new line into backer lines. And then loop over all the backer lines. I'll call this line, I guess. Line in backer lines. Oh, damn. I gotta replace these. Nice, you got a MacBook Pro now? Sweet. Yeah, nice script, dude. Yeah, nice script. That's real handy, right? Especially with uploading and all that. Okay, so this is gonna be kind of different how this does the strings. Wanna make it so the string, so there's two credit strings. Credits begin and credits end. We need to add two new lines on the edges of these. Okay. Right? It was way harder than it should have been. I totally, yeah. Yeah, I hear you. But once you got them all set up, then you're good to go. You got a nice script. Totally. Those help. Okay, so I'm splitting the backers text into new lines, looping over all of them. It's written in Java? Oh yeah, right. I've seen that. What's up, Colleen? Okay, for each one of these lines, if it's a nah or a new line, then just delete it. Shoot. So remove if, no, delete if, No. I forget what this function I have is. That not a function, it's a macro actually. Erase elements in the vector backer lines. Function to erase takes a const string ref. Return the string is nah, or the string is capital nah. String equals just new line or empty. We should be first. So there, now the backer lines are cleaned up. So last gold backer 0. If line dot find k last gold, or it just actually contains line k last gold backer. Last gold backer equals index or count or. Actually, just break. There, so now we got the all the backers all processed. What's a macro? A macro is just a C preprocessor thing. Do you know what the preprocessor is? Basically, it's a pound define. It's just a replace. So the preprocessor is a thing that runs before the compiler, and it basically takes something and replaces it with something else before it even compiles it. So you can do a lot of crazy, crazy stuff with macros that would not be allowed in regular code, and they're actually kind of somewhat dangerous and not recommended to use all the time. So this is something that I kind of had to write a macro for this function, though there was no good way to do this without writing a macro, so I had to do it. Oh, I guess the reason was because I didn't want to write a template function for this. Nice pizza. Platform Labs, when I started Songbringer, did I focus on player movement and functionality? No. You can see from the very first days what I was working on. I just started on simple systems like health system, and then movement and things like that. But no, the game has kind of refined itself over lots and lots of time. So really, each day it's kind of gotten better and better and better. So I know I didn't really focus on any one area at first. I kind of just had to get the game running at first, Okay, so that should have the last gold backer. So now I can take the. Let's call this begin. Call this end. Begin, replace, format, la la, end, replace, form. Oh. So now we got credits lines, backer lines. Actually, split begin into lines. You guys can't even read what I'm coding, but I'm basically processing the backers.txt file in a new way so that I can show all the backers as all the gold backers in a special color. Okay. Which one was the song we released? I think you did. I don't remember though. Was it last week or something? You're trying to read the fuzz? Gotta squint really hard. Okay, so there's the split function. Does that erase elements? It does. That's a bad thing. But oh well, I don't want to recompile. So let's go backer lines, begin lines, and end lines. All right. Oh, it's a picture of Songbringer hidden inside a house. Nice. Right? It's a double internet whammy today. Mighty Nest, yo! Oh, cool. I'm glad, dude. Yeah, I'm updating that almost daily. So there'll be another update to Steam tonight, which has some very important bug fixes and the credits scene. So you can actually complete the game now. It'll have some cool stuff like that. And any other kind of bugs I can get fixed on the Trello. Yeah, all you can see is colors, just blocks of color. Okay, so now I just want to combine all these lines. Can you add two vectors together? That's possible, right? No, it's not. How do you add two vectors? All right, sorry about that, guys. Oh, vector.insert, that's right. Begin lines, insert. Begin lines. Actually, let's call this lines instead of begin lines. It's going to get belabored really fast. So I'm calling this lines. I'm just combining all the lines now that they're all processed. Yeah, it's because when the game's actually playing, it's a pixel art game, so it can easily display that many. The code looks like the script that GIF has. Okay, so lines insert, lines dot end, lines dot, oh no, backer lines dot begin, backer lines dot end. Lines on insert, lines on end, end lines dot begin, end lines dot end. Okay, I'm ready to run this finally. Yeah, it probably won't help that much for you to even be watching at a better thing, because it's the problem is my upload speed, which, God willing, will be better next week. So yeah, there'll be a whole story sequence when that's running. All right, we still got the credits lines. Oh, forgot about adding in some new lines. Okay, we gotta add in a couple more new lines here. And oh yeah, time to make all these gold too. So I want to make sure that ran right. What is the recommended amount of dedicated RAM to run Songbringer? I don't know. It doesn't have to be that much. I would say a gig is fine. All right, Jonah, see you, man. Thanks for stopping by. Okay, I'm just debugging to make sure that it processed the gold backer. Yeah, last gold backer line 47. All right, so now that I've got this number that's the representation of what the last gold backer is. Oh, watch the video. Oh. Dedoated woman, wham.
Next question on this left side.
I was wondering, what's the recommended amount of dedicated wham I should have to the server?
Whoa.
I'm sorry, could you please repeat your question?
Dedicated wham to a server.
Oh,
If you're
how
running
much
off your
RAM?
PC.
Oh, okay.
It's depending on plugins and players.
Yeah, so it's really depend. This is a technical question you're asking, how much RAM?
They're just trying to like be graceful about it. Let's see. So if the count is less than the last gold backer, it's gonna make this label gold. Else. Okay, so I gotta look up the gold color now. Dead-awaited wham. Kids do say the darndest things. Oh, there it is. Gold. Like that. This gold might be different than the other gold, so I'm just going to keep them separate. Same conference?
How much money do you have?
Is that Notch? Whoa. Oh, yeah, he had autism though. Oh. Yeah, look like Notch. All right, cool. Yeah, we got some gold colors. Those might need to be toned down a little bit. They're kind of a little bit too bright compared to the background. But I'm gonna make sure they get all the right golds, so all y'all's names are in the right gold color. Yep. Cool, Tibbetts is the last one, nice. Okay, so a little bit dark, a tiny bit darker. Oh, also pushing back only one new line. Yeah, you're gold. You're gold. You guys are gold now. So maybe more like that. Let's try that. E3. Yeah, right? It's just pleasing, right? Yeah, Pedro, it's not going to be quite the same gold color as the Star Trek. I started with that, but it's going to be different here because this has a different background and it's just going to look better with its own custom gold color. Yeah, make the credits of a video game, right? Bucket list checked off. I need to make this go faster for debugging purposes. Yeah, that's a little bit better now. Right? Just tone down that gold so you can see the gold a little bit more and less. It's less white. Maybe even a touch less. Just a tiny bit less. Ooh, secret area where the item was already found. I wonder which one that was. Stayed off. Oh no, your build failed? Let's do one more. One more little notch downwards, more like toot, 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 like that. I think that'll look a little better. Okay, now I'm gonna show it at super speed, or not quite super speed, but fast speed, so I can watch the whole thing. Oh, you've been taking screenshots of the credits? Nice. It'll still be in the game, man. You can totally play it and get that far. It shouldn't be that hard to beat the game. Okay, here's fast mode, but I want to watch the whole credits and make sure this all works. In fact, I think the background should be a little brighter, especially these outdoor scenes, because it's all nighttime, so you can't see anything. Yeah, so maybe it should force the game into not being nighttime. Like that one's totally black. if it's even there. Is it there? It might have broken. All right, Platformer Labs. All right, man, see ya. Oh, yeah, it was just a really dark area. Okay, it worked. Awesome. Got a credit sequence. Yeah, I'm going to make it a little lighter, though. So let's see it not quite in super fast. And the fade opacity. Instead of 64, let's do like 128. All right, Bunny. See you, man. Have a great night. Stay warm. Yeah, remember to send me an email. Send me your email address. Yeah, that's a little bit better, being able to see more. It's not quite as dark for those background areas. So thankful for all, man, so many backers. Hey, there's Songbringer. It's kind of fun watching which areas you're going to get. Hey, that's the same area. What's the chances of that? Showed exactly the same area twice. Wait a minute. That looks like the same area too. But that's not. I don't know, pizza. I don't know how you would do that. Yeah, I could make an already shown list. That would be, yeah, let's see that. But just in case, you know. Since this is a lambda callback, I'm going to make a static vector or map, like a static map of v3i's hash type to boolean. Has it been snowing in the mountains? Yeah, it totally has. Yeah, you got, oh man, it's so great. You live in a cool place where you got tons of snow. We don't really get a lot of snow here in my part of Northern California, but up in the mountains, they get plenty of snow. So if we've already got, if we already done dot count key type is going to be p dot hash. It's greater than zero. Then we can return. Otherwise, we mark this one as already done. So already done dot insert, or just no, already done p dot hash equals true. If I were to make a cross-platform for iOS, how would I get the game into my iPhone? I'm not sure how that works for Unity. I don't know how they do that, but I would guess you would probably need a developer. No, you know what? I don't think you even need a developer account anymore. I think Apple made it more friendly, and you can just put your game on your iPhone somehow. Oh, stayed off. Yeah, that's on the Trello list to fix. Yes. So thank you. Thanks for mentioning that. That's on the Trello. It's right here. It's called Can Walk South onto Bombo Pillars, Water, etc. So I'll definitely get to fixing that one. That was one of my, it's an important one. It's a yellow, it's marked yellow, so it's pretty important, and it's up there on the list too. So right. Okay, so this time it shouldn't ever show the same area twice. So you need a developer account only if you want to publish, right? Yeah. Hey, thanks, Zadoff. I'm so glad. So we had a vote today earlier on the stream of when the game should be beta. I was kind of thinking it should be beta like next week or whatever, you know, like just kind of get into the beta phase faster than whatever. But most people voted that the it should be like a month from now. And so beta is officially going to be February 21st, 2016, which is 30 years to the date from the release of Zelda 1. So it's a very special day. Okay, I still need to make it so it should be daytime so you can see all these areas. Yeah, thanks, Zadoff. Yeah. It's definitely been a lot added since the last alpha. Red Sands, what's up, man? I'm working on the end of the game, so the game is now completable. So you can get through the whole game and get even to this credit sequence, and technically you can complete the game now. There's no ending story sequence or anything yet. There's nothing of that kind. I'm just making it so you can technically complete the game. Yeah. Yeah, so this will make it more fulfilling. If you're playing the alpha right now, you can be fulfilled with this, you know, with the fact that you actually beat the game. You know, this, you can say, yep, I beat the game, and something actually happens. Okay. The only thing, it would be nice if I made it so it's like always lit or always sunset or always brighter. GNZ, can I put your name up there? Sure, man. Right now, these are all backers. These are people that have actually pre-ordered the game. So, but yeah, email me. I think I'm gonna check this in so far. This is a pretty good place to check in. I think changing the daylight time would change your actual game time. So that would kind of mess with people's timing of their speed run. You know, like how long did it take you to complete the game? Yeah. Where's that one line though? Oh, there it is. Okay. Cool. So I'm checking this in. This is a pretty good progress so far. Actually, probably be better to next make it so. Let's put in a line here that says something like. So it would be nice if they were all daylight. Man, yeah, the stream's working, but sorry, the quality's bad. It's because of my upload speeds. Yeah, the game time should definitely stop right at the very end. Which I'm going to do next. I'm going to make it so there's a tally. So I'm just checking into Git now. Oh, wait. Oh yeah, I guess that's fine. Okay, so this is showing areas of the game during the credits. Okay, let me check how much time I got left on the stream because I'm already starting to get hungry. Oh, it's been 2 hours already. Yeah. Let me play the game a little bit though. I'll show you guys a cool sequence. Fighting, I'll just go through level 9 and play it right now. Reagan Knight, what's up? Yeah, why not win? No, the game is not quite near finished, but it's almost done with its core features. So the official beta start of this game is going to be February 21st. And right now the game is... how do I say it? It's looking really good. So I'm turning off some of the doors that I already opened in this level 9. I'm just going to play level 9. Eight, nine, nine, two, eight, one, two, nine, nine. There's a lot of these nines that are already open. Okay, so I turned off all nines doors, turned off all nines keys, turned off nines switches. I'm gonna play the game a little bit. I think that should be all. So now I'm gonna start the player. Yeah, that looks good. Turn on the get my Xbox controller out, ready to go. Reagan Knight, what's up? A Fool's Duty, Songbringer is coming great. Yeah, no, it's not quite the finish line. No, it's not the finish line, but it is almost all the core features are done. So sorry about the stream quality today. The audio is kind of crap, and so is the video. But at least it's a stream. I'm having bad upload speed. So I just made the credits for the game, so you can actually complete the game now. And I'm just going to play level 9 now, and that's going to be in the end of the stream. So I'll probably stream for another 15 minutes. Oh, wow. Noob Ninjas assembling a Hackintosh on Twitch. Wow. How do you hook up your Xbox controller to the game? You just plug it in. You mean the code? If you're talking about code, then it's different for you because you're using Unity, so you need to use Unity's like controller stuff. So I'm on level 9 right now. I've got some good items. I got the poison top hat. I've got regular bombs. I've got plenty of cactuses. I got lots of bombs. I got the ghost sword. Wait, what kind of ghost sword do I have? I have the ice sword. I don't need any more diamonds. I can just skip those. So all these guys have a little bit more health. Yeah, if I hit the sword just right, I can hit it diagonally too. To play the game, hook in it. Like, do you need a wired controller for that? No. No, you can use wired or wireless. Do you mean for this game? If you're talking about this game, all you gotta do is plug it in and it'll work. Wired or wireless. Yep, sliding inventory. Sorry, you're looking at kind of a buggier version of the visuals of the game because I'm working on making it so there's no more letterboxing. So if I open up my inventory right now, it's a little bit off. It's supposed to show the whole screen, but that's because I'm working on removing the letterboxing. Basically, it's not really that I'm removing letterboxing, it's that I'm adding extra content so that the game can actually display at a full resolution. So yeah, the game looks a little bit weird right now. But it'll be fixed before tonight. So. Before tonight, I'll have this all uploaded to Steam, all the new stuff. So anybody that has the alpha version, you'll be able to play it tonight. What website do I use to back up? I have my own. I don't use a website for that. But you can, if you want your own private repo, you can use Bitbucket or GitHub. And there's probably other ones out there too, but Bitbucket's pretty nice because you can do your own private repos on there for free. Yeah, Manic, it's been a minute since I've seen you. I hope you've been good, man. Yes, yeah, I'm going to update the Steam build tonight. So everything I've done today will be up on Steam so you guys can play the newest stuff. Oh, I already have the map for this. Damn, I should have deleted my map. It's kind of cheating. Wait, I can't remember where I've been and where I haven't. Looks like I haven't been here. Or have I? Oh, damn! I can't even tell what's going on! Button mashing! Button mash forever! Oh, dude, two wizards and stuff. Yes, cactus definitely helps here. Bombs definitely help. Good thing I had lots of health before I came into this room. Oh god, these wizards suck. dude. Oh, there. Give me some cactus. Cactus power. I also made it recently so that using a cactus gives you one part of life back again. Yeah, this room was so fun. Right? The spiders really added a lot of fun to this room here. They just kept, they made so much more stuff to blow up. Oh no, I'm almost dead! Oh, that was close. Chip's going crazy. Woo! I'm excited that I actually beat that room. That was tough. Thanks, pizza. It's getting there. It's like a lot of it's accidental, you know, like just making switch rooms, these kind of things, just it was fun to like make tons of enemies. Right on, pizza. Man, you definitely gotta wait a long time for Chip to scan all those spiders. But you get a lot of health from it. It's worth it. Done? Oh, he's not done. Yeah, good job, Jim. Oh, he still wasn't done. Oh, no. Whoa, this is an interesting one. Makes it hard with these pulverizer guys. Kicked in here. What do you mean a game crash is coming? Like, you talking about them, like the industry of AAA games is going to have a crash? It's hard to see these guys in the corners because the light's so low. It actually makes it really challenging. But that's what level 9 is, right? You could reflect those blue things back at the eyeballs. Oh, that would be cool. I mean, you are going to have a shield item, so maybe the shield should do that. God, this room is really hard. Oh, there's like no way to get past there. Got him. Production values rising. Soon they run out of methods to make a profit. I hear ya. I'm low on health. Pizza sword. What does the pizza sword do? No, that's this guy. Yeah. He's the one breathing. Oh, no. Oh, shit. Oh. Well, makes your eardrums bleed with bagpipes. Gives you a snack after a tough battle. Well, yeah, that's going to be it for today's stream, guys. What am I going to do? I'm going to do lots of bug fixes and then get the game uploaded to Steam for tonight. So thanks for watching. Hope you all had a great time. And hopefully sometime by this next week I can get my internet fixed so I can do quality streams again. But yeah, until next time, appreciate y'all. Have a good night. Have a good day. Enjoy yourselves. See you guys.